How's it going, everyone? It's Nick here from TraderLine. This is a very highly requested video, so here is introduction to the option Greeks. In this video, we're going to cover Delta, Gamma, Theta, and Vega. However, it's only going to be an introduction. There's enough information about all of these Greeks that they could each have their own video, so I'm just going to touch the very basics. Delta measures the impact of a change in the price of the underlying. The amount that the option price is expected to move based on a $1 move in the underlying stock. For calls, your delta is going to be between 0 and 1, and for puts, the delta is going to be between 0 and negative 1. So if you look over here, I've got an option chain on Amazon. So right now, Amazon's trading at about 1885, and these are August 10th expiration. So if you're to buy out of the money, let's say a $1,900 call, your delta is going to be 0.32. So for every $1 that Amazon moves up, your contracts are going to move up 32 cents. For every $1 that Amazon moves up, each one of your contracts will move up 32 cents. If you're going to buy in the money, let's choose 1830 strike right here. We go over to the left, you see that the delta is 0.93. So for every $1 that Amazon moves up, each one of your contracts will move up 93 cents. So you can see the farther in the money that you are, the higher the delta. The farther out of the money that you are, the lower the delta. Next up is gamma. So gamma measures the rate of change of the delta. So if you think of delta as the speed at which the option price changes, then gamma is going to be the rate that it accelerates. The larger the gamma equals, the more volatile the price of the option will be. So options priced at or near the money will have a larger gamma. Options priced deep in or deep out of the money will have a smaller gamma. Since the options delta is only valid for a short period of time, because as the price fluctuates, it's going to change, the gamma is going to give you an idea of how the delta is expected to change over time as the underlying price of the stock changes. This is because when an option is near or at the money, a small change in the underlying will have a big impact on demand for that contract. For options that are deep in the money or deep out of the money, demand's not going to change much for a change in the underlying asset's value. Theta is a measure of the rate of decline in the value of an option due to decay. So whenever we're talking about time decay, we're always talking about theta. To keep it simple, if everything else stays constant, the value of the option will lose value over time. So if you look over here, this was the Amazon bear that we've seen come hit our scanner. So these are August 17th puts, and you could see if Amazon was to stay at 1860, today you would be down 224. Tomorrow, if it stayed at 1860, you would be down 297. The next day, if it stays at 1860, you'll be down 373. And so you could see that from the stock not doing anything, you're losing money. So look at this. Even if Amazon does happen to go down 1840 today, you might be up $902, but if you hang on to that contract as it gets closer to expiration, that 902, due to the time decay, is only going to be worth $55. So again, look at this. You could be up 290 if Amazon went down to 1850, but if it stays at 1850 and you're still holding on to those puts at the time of expiration, you're going to be down $945. So theta, I'm going to end up creating a video for that one specifically because there's a lot of information. But basically, the more intrinsic value that the option has, the less decay exposure. The more extrinsic value that it has equals the more decay exposure. So if we use an example, again, keeping things very simple for this introduction, the initial option price is $10. The theta is minus 0.25. Then after one day, if nothing else changes and that stock stays the exact same and doesn't move, that option is now going to be worth $9.75. Now, if you look over at this chart here, time decay, you could see that as you get closer to the expiration, the time decay picks up. So the value of your option decreases significantly. Look how the value changes from 120 days to 90 days to expiration compared to 30 days to 0 days. So the majority of that decay is going to come in the last 30 days. A lot of times people do not pay attention to theta and they'll buy an option and it's just not going anywhere and they're losing money and they don't understand why. Something else that I see happen all the time, someone will buy a very short-term option. Let's use Amazon as an example. If I bought these August 17th puts and Amazon went down to 1830, I would close out the option and take my $1,600 profit because it's going to keep on decaying. So what a lot of people do is they wait for it to go down. And yeah, if Amazon goes down to 1820, the next day you'll make a lot more money. But if it doesn't move, or if it moves back up, you're going to lose money significantly. So you need to be aware of theta. You need to be aware of how it works because it's a very important piece of the puzzle. Last one that we're going to cover here is Vega. So Vega is a measurement of an option's price sensitivity to changes in volatility of the underlying. It represents the amount that an option price changes in reaction to a 1% change in IV. Implied volatility needs a video all on its own, but just to sum it up, implied volatility is basically what the market thinks a stock's historical volatility will be in the future based on options. So with the implied volatility moving up, since the momentum of the option is more likely to go in your way, you're now going to pay more for that option. This is why a lot of times when you have people betting on earnings, they position themselves much farther out so they can buy that option without the implied volatility. If you buy an option for earnings the day right before they report, you're going to be paying heavily for that implied volatility because there's a ton of people doing the exact same thing. So if everyone thinks Amazon's going to go up from earnings, everyone's going to pile in, and that implied volatility is going to move up, which means the price of your option is going to move up as well. So that's it for this very basic introduction to the Greeks. I am going to go into them more in detail individually, but I think this is a good start just so you kind of understand what to look for, what they mean, and why they're important. You could see that options have a lot more components than just trading stocks, and you have to be aware of how all of these calculations affect your trade. If you don't understand how all of these Greeks factor in and affect the price of your option, then you could be just basically giving away money carelessly. So you need to understand how they work, and hopefully this video gave you that brief overview. So I hope this video was helpful. If anyone has any questions, as always, please don't hesitate to reach out. Otherwise, have a great rest of your day, and I'll see everybody soon.